President-elect Biden says one of his top priorities will be to reinstate the Dreamers program. The program allows children of undocumented immigrants to live and work in the United States without threat of being deported. Well, 2 years ago, we introduced you to Hilda Ramirez and her now 14-year-old son. They fled violence in Guatemala 6 years ago. Today, they remain in a North Austin church where they've been for 4 years, taking sanctuary and fearful of deportation under the Trump administration. Our Candy Rodriguez checked back in with the family to find out if their plans might change when new leadership in the White House.
It's a life in North Austin spent in fear.
It's been very difficult having to live every day locked up. Yvonne's never been able to have a normal childhood.
Hilda Ramirez and her son Yvonne first arrived to the U.S. from Guatemala in late 2014. Barack Obama was president. She sought asylum, but was denied. Hilda says her primary language is mom, and she had trouble communicating in Spanish at her hearing.
I didn't understand the questions they asked me. They didn't even provide a translator who could speak my native language.
Thanks to the Austin Sanctuary Network, she ended up here at a Presbyterian church in North Austin. And that's where she and Yvonne have been living for the last 4 years.
When Donald Trump became president, it got hard to deal with the threats from the U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement Department.
Now, with Joe Biden being named president-elect, Hilda is hopeful.
I would ask him to remove my deportation order and let me be free with my son.
Those with the Austin Sanctuary Network say they're ready to work and help the Ramirezes win their freedom.
If we have a President Biden, it's time for the Democrats to fulfill their promises and their debt to immigrants all over the country.
Just because Biden won, it does not mean we will sit back and relax. The fight is not over.
Hilda's son, Yvonne, now has a child's visa. So while he's protected for now, his mother is not. And just to give you an idea, the Austin Sanctuary Network is a collective of around 30 churches across the area. Currently, there are 3 people seeking sanctuary here in the city, and that includes Hilda and Yvonne. Back to you.
Well, just last month, immigrant rights groups, including the Austin Sanctuary Network, released documents obtained through a Freedom of Information Act lawsuit. In it, the groups learned U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement officials were targeting sanctuary leaders with hefty civil fines. 9 people taking sanctuary in churches across the country received fines. Altogether, it was around $3 million. So just last year, we are told Ramirez was hit with a $300,000 fine. Ramirez continues to fight her case in court.